Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we will discuss Vrana-Shofa in detail. But before entering directly into Vrana-Shofa, first I will tell you what is Shofa. It's Nidana, Purvarupa, Samprapti, Lakshanas, etc. So that we can cover the topics regarding Shofa from Sushrutasamhitha 17th chapter, that is Amapakveshini Adhyaya, Charakasutrasthana 18th chapter, Trishothi Adhyaya, Shofa Chikitsa from Sushruta Chikitsa Sthana 23rd chapter, Ashtanga Hridaya Nidana 13th chapter and Ashtanga Hridaya Chikitsa 17th chapter. Ayurvedic texts have the term Shofa and Shotha to indicate swelling or edema, and these have been used loosely and interchangeably for all the three kinds of swelling. There is another term called Vrana Shofa, which is described as earlier phase of Vrana. It denotes swelling leading to a wound or ulcer, or having a wound or ulcer already. Charakasamhitha is having detailed description of Shotha along with its classification, symptomatology, complication and management. Acharya Sushruta had complete knowledge of Vrana and their management along with its untimely and untreated complications. He mentioned in detail about Vrana Shofa. The surgical aspects about Shofa and Vrana drew more attention by Acharya Sushruta. He described Vrana-Shofa into three progressive stages, namely Amavastha, Pachyamanavastha and Pakvavastha. Based on the vishesan of dosha, Sushruta has described Vrana-Shofa into six types: Vatika, Paitika, Kaphaja, Shonitaja, Sannipataja and Agantuja. Chatkriyakala was also explained for the first time in this context. Out of Vrana-Shashti Upakrama, first 11, that is from Abhatarpana to Virechana, were mentioned for Vrana-Shofa specially, and rest of other 48 procedures were truly for Vrana only. Shofa Nirukti from Sushruta Sutra Sthana 17th chapter Amapakveshini Adhyaya. Shofa Samuthana Granthi Vidrati Alaji Prabhratayaha Prayana Vyadhayo Abhihita Anikakritayaha Tair Vilakshanaha Pridur Gratitaha Samo Vishamo Vatvang Mamsasthai Dosha Sankataha Sharire Regade Shothitaha Shofa Ityuchate. Vrana Shotha is that condition which is characterized by a swelling which is like in Granthi, Vidrati, Allergy, etc. There is one thing to note, that though it is also a swelling, it is different from Granthi, Vidrati or Allergy. Vidrati and allergy are inflammatory swellings, while Granthi is due to abnormal growth of tissues and not considered as any kind of edema or swelling. Vrana Shofa is Gratitha. It is Sama or Vishama, that is regular or irregular, located in the plane of skin and muscles, that is Tvak Mamsas Thai, and it is also a localized lesion. Inflammation. Inflammation and edema associated with it is duly recognized in Ayurveda as a pathological manifestation, while modern medicine considers inflammation as a symptom, or rather as a healing response of the body in wounds. Inflammation is characterized by, first one, increased blood flow to the injured area, secondary to the dilatation of local blood vessels, second one, leakage of plasma from the vessels due to increased permeability of the capillary walls, third one, large number of granulocytes and monocytes migrate to the injured area, and the fourth one is localized swelling or edema. Ayurveda treats the concept of inflammation as a symptom of a disease, an independent disease and complication of diseases. Another definition of Vrana Shotha is from Ashtanga Hridaya Sutra Sthana 29th chapter 1st loka, Vrana Sanjayate Prayah Pakat Shvayatu Purvakat. Vrana or an ulcer is formed secondary to inflammation of a swelling. Vranaya Shothaha Vrana Shothaha. These are the different classification of Shotha according to various acharyas. This is the Karana Bheda and Sthana Bheda classification. Karana Bheda into Nija and Agantuja. Nija is again classified into Vataja, Pittaja and Kaphaja Shotha. Agantuja to Aghataja and Asatmyaja. Sthana Bhedena Sarvanga, Eganga and Arthanga. Another one is Urdhvagata, Madhyagata, Adhogata and Sarvasara. In Trishothi Adhyaya of Charaka, he tells that there are three types of swellings caused by Vata, Pitta and Kapha. They are again classified into Nija and Agantuja. According to Sushruta, six types: Vataja, Pittaja, Kaphaja, Rektaja, Sannipataja and Agantuja. These are the diseases in which there will be Sthanika Shodha. The dosha involved, sthana and lakshanas are mentioned in this table. Akriti Anusara classification, that is three types, Prithu, Unnata and Gradhita, is mentioned by Vagbhata. And Satya Sadhya Anusara classification, Urdhva, Adha and Madhyama is told by Madhava Nidana. Vishaja Shodha, Hetu is Garopayoga, Dushtatoya Sevana and Prakupidodaka Avagaha. Its lakshanas are Mridu Kshiprothana, that is Shikra Utpanna, Avalambi, Chala or Achala. Nidanas of Nija and Aganduja Shodha is explained in Charaka's Trishodhi Adhyaya, 4th and 6th Shloka. Aganduja Shodha will subside when treated with Bandha, Mantra, Agada, Pralepa, Pratapa, Nirvapanadi, Upakramas. In Agantuja Shofa, the Lakshanas appear first and Doshik involvement takes place later. But in Nija Shofa, depending upon the Doshik involvement and Prakopa, the Lakshanas appear. Samprapti of Eganga Shofa, Dosha situated in Vaksha causes Urdhva Bhaga Shofa, and similarly those situated in Madhya, Atho, Sarvanga and Pratyanga causes respective Bhaga Shofa. Acharya Sushruta perceived that the samprapti of shofa has a definite sequential pattern distributed over six occasions for treatment called Shatkriyakala. These are respectively as Chaya, Prakopa, Prasara, Sthana Samshraya, Vyakta and Bhedavastha. Ushma, Davadhu and Sirayama. These are the Shodha Purvarupa. Samanya Lakshanas of Shodha, Gavravam, Anavasthidatvam, Utsedha. Utsedha is a classification of Charaka and it is also the Pratyatma Lakshana of Shodha. Ushma, Siratanutvam, Loma Harsha and Anga Vivarnata. Vrana Vastus are Dvak, Mamsa, Siras, Nayu, Asthi, Sandhi, Koshta and Marma. Next is types of Shofa and their characteristics. Vataja Vrana Shodha, according to Sushrutasamhitha Sutra Sthana 17th chapter 4th Shloka. Here, the area of Ranashodha appears Krishna or Aruna in Varna, Parusha, Mridu, Anavasthita and Todha Dayaha Vedana. It is associated with varieties of pain like pricking, cutting type, etc. Pittaja Ranashodha will be having features like Pita, Mridu, Sarekta, Shikranusari and Oshadi Vedana Visheshatva will be there. The color will be yellowish or yellowish with reddish tinge. Soft, spreads fast and having different types of pain like osha, chosha, daha, etc. Kafaja will be Pandu in Varna, Katina, Snigdha, Shita, Manda Anusari and Kandwadi Vedana Visheshatva will be there. Sannipataja will be having mixed features. Shonita Vranashodha features are same as that manifested in Pittaja Vranashodha and the swelling is Ati Krishna in Varna. Agantuja will be having the same features as in Pittaja and Rektaja Vranashodha and the color of the swelling has similarity to Rekta. From this table, you can understand the Sthana, Uttana, Varna, Sparsha and Lakshana of Vataja, Pittaja and Kafaja Shodha respectively as told in Trishodhiya Adhyaya. Stages of Vranashofa. Acharya Sushruta has described three stages of Ranashodha and they are Amavastha, Pachyamanavastha and Pakvavastha. Amavastha is the stage of unripe abscess or stage of early inflammation. Acharya Sushruta told Mandoshmata, Tvaksavarna, Shita Shofa, Sthairya, Mandavedana and Alpa Shofa. And according to Acharya Vagbhata, Alpa Shofa, Alposhma, Alparuk, Samavarna, Katina and Sthira. This stage results due to vitiated doshas and the defending doshas. In this stage, kapha dosha may be prominent due to which a swelling is produced. Feeling of cold or hot in duration, dull pain, mild inflammation, etc. can be seen. Pachyamanavastha is the stage of ripening abscess or inflammatory stage. It is the stage in which if the vitiated doshas are further allowed to produce more exaggerated phase in which the prakupita pitta will act upon the dushya to produce disintegration. The features are Suchibhiriva Nistudyate, pain as if being pricked by needles. Dashyate Iva Pipilikabihi, pain as if being bitten by ants. Tabihi samsarpyate, sensation of ants crawling over the area. Chidyate iva shastrena, pain as if being cut by instruments. Pidyate panina, pain as if being pressed by palm. Khatyate iva angulya, pain as if being squeezed by fingers. Dahyate pachyate iva cha agni kshaarabhyam, pain as if being burnt by application of kshara or agni. Osha chosha paridaha, burning or sucking type of pain over and around the swelling. The person does not find comfort in sitting, lying or sleeping as though being stung by scorpion. That is Vrishchika Vitta Iva. The swelling appears like Atmadabasti, that is, appears like a bladder filled with water or like a bag distended with air. There will be Tvak Vivarnata, Shobha Vivritti, Jwara, Daha, Pipasa, Bhaktaruji, etc. The third stage is Pakvavastha. It is the stage of suppuration. Further, in relation to dosha dosha samurchana, the dhatus are affected and burnt. There is an attempt for absorption, that is shoshana by vayu, due to which following signs and symptoms are produced. Vedana upashanti, panduta, alpa shofata, vali pradurbhava, tvak pariputana, nimna darshanam angulyava pedite pratyunnamanam. The swelling gets depressed when pressed, and when pressure is released, swells up to the former size. Basta vivodaka sancharanam puyasya prabidayatyeka mantamante chava pidite. That means the fluid or pus within the swelling moves. This can be felt by pressing the swelling at one end and feeling the thrill by a finger at the other end of the swelling. There will be kandu unnatata, that is increased swelling in the dependent area due to collected pus. The various inflammatory symptoms will reduce and the patient gets back interest for having food, that is bhakta abhikangsha. Sadhya and asadhya vrana lakshanas are mentioned here. Why chikitsa is essential? The shofa, which is either mild or profound, if left untreated, becomes raised up and undergoes paka. The deep-seated doshas, that is pus, etc., that is improperly cooked, spread widely and irregularly and become krichra sadhya. If the shofa doesn't subside even after the application of alepa, visravana, shodhana, etc., all properly done, but still it is found to be sama, have alpamula, and pindidascha upari unnata, that is bulging up like a round mass, then it should be understood as going to ripen quickly. Shodha chikitsa. The physician, after ascertaining bala, dosha and kala, should treat the ailment by administering therapies contradicting the nidana, doshas and ritu. Samanya chikitsa of shodha. If it is amajanya, then lankhana, pachana, shodhana. If it is located in Shira Pradesha, then Shiro Virechanadis. If it is located in Adho Bhaga, then Virechana. And in Urdhva Bhaga, Vamana can be done. If it is caused by improper Snehana, then give Rukshana therapy. And if it is due to improper Rukshana, then give Snehana therapy. In Pitta Anilaja, Kridam Satiktakam. In Murcha Arati Daha, Payascha Tarpite, Vishodhaniye Samutre. In Kaphothitha, Kshara Katushna Dravyas are given. Charaka Chikitsa 12th chapter, Shvaitu Chikitsa Adhyaya, we can find the treatment based on doshas. Agantucha Shodha is treated based upon the external factor involved. And here the Shodha develops mainly by Vata and Rekta. So Visarpavat Chikitsa or Vata Rektavat Chikitsa can be done. Management of Vrana Shofa. The Vrana Shofa should be managed in early stage to avoid suppuration and more tissue harm, as described in stages of Shat Kriya Kala. There are different kinds of management required in different stages of Shofa, like in Amavastha, that is early stage, only Vimlapana, Snehana, Alepa, Upanaha are needed for the treatment, while in Pakvavastha, surgical procedures like Bhedana, etc. are needed. Shodhana and Ropana measures are adopted for the management of Vrana, and Vaikritapaha Chikitsa is adopted to remove the scar formed during the process of Vrana Ropana. Vrana Shofa Sapta Upakrama. Adav Vimlapanam Kuryat Dvitiyam Avasechanam Tritiyam Upanaham Tu Chaturthim Patana Kriyam Panchamam Shodhanam Kuryat Shashtam Ropanam Ishyate Ete Krama Vranasyokta Saptamam Vaikritapaham. They are seven in number. വിംലാപന അവസേചന ഉപനാഹ പാട്ടന ശോധന രോപണ ആൻഡ് വൈകൃതാപഹ ചികിത്സ From the Vrana Shashti Upakrama itself, the first 11 measures, that is from Apatarpana till Virejana, are specifically mentioned for the management of Vrana Shodha, but can also be used for treating Vrana. Apatarpana Madhi Upakramaha Esha Sarva Shofanam Samanyaha Pradhana Tamasya. From Sushruta Chikitsa, first chapter 11 Shloka. Among these 11 procedures, Apatarpana is the first procedure and important procedure because it can be adopted in all varieties of shodha. What is Vimlapana? The swellings which are fixed and less painful are subjected to snehana and svedana and then pressed using hands or by thumb. Procedure not only includes pressing or squeezing but also includes other measures like pralepa, parisheka, abhyanga, etc. which basically helps in subduing and liquefying the doshas in the shodha. Next is upanaha. Upanaha can be used from the perspective of either suppressing the vrana shodha in the amavastha itself or for accelerating the paka in a pachamana shodha. Avasejana or visravana. The shofa which is having a severe degree of inflammation and pain and does not respond to lepa, svedana, parisheka, apatarpana, etc. respond well to avasejana. According to Bhaisaja Ratnavali, avasejana procedure doesn't indicate just bloodletting but includes all those measures like vamana, virechana, etc. which basically clean the internal environment of the body. This avasejana includes all shodhana procedures. In Vrana contaminated with Visha, Rekta Mokshana using Jalauka plays an important role. Rekta is the major dosha to cause Shodha, hence Rekta is let off to weaken the disease process. Sneha Pana helps to control the vitiated Vata, invigorates the local Dhatvakni and helps to reduce the Shodha. Vamana is more fruitful in conditions when there is excessive swelling caused due to Kapha and where systemically also Kapha has got vitiated to a greater extent. If the shodha is long-standing and caused by vitiation of vata and pitta, it has to be managed by virechana. Pathyas are jangala mamsarasa, savarchala, patola, moolaka, kulatha, pippali, yusha, agnimantha, nimbapatra, purana shali, anna, etc. Apathyas are anupa mamsa, guda, guru padartha, amla and levana padartha, madhya, prakriti viparita ahara, tilataila siddha padartha. These are some yogas. Vranashofa upadravas are chardi, shwasa, aruchi, trishna, jwara, atisara and daurbalya. Arishta lakshanas are shodha starting from pada and spreading upwards, starting from mukha and spreading downwards, starting from guhya bhaga and upadravayukta shodha. Here ends the topic shodha as well as vranashodha. Thank you for watching.